Hi everybody, my name is Mr. Campbell from Mr. Campbell Rocks. Welcome back to another tutorial. Today we're going to talk about how to create appointment slots in Google Calendar, and this is 2020 version. So first of all, we're going to go to calendar.google.com, or if you go to your waffle, you can go down here to where click on calendar. It'll take you to the same place. So what we're going to do, let me just make this full screen. Is we want to go up here to where it says create and the little plus Google sign, and we want to create a new event. You're going to see three options for an event, an out of office, or appointment slots. So those are the three options that you have when creating an event. Now what we're going to do here is we're just going to do test for YouTube. And then we're going to click on appointment slots. Now, when we have appointment slots, it's going to ask us what duration do we want those appointment slots to be in. So let's talk about some real world examples, right? If you're a school and you're doing checkout with your teachers, maybe you're doing parent-teacher conference with, again, next year, right where we're at with COVID and all those things. Maybe you're doing them digitally on over Meet or Zoom, and you need to have appointment slots that way. Maybe you're doing progress reports with individual students and their families, like midterms or different things like that. Maybe you're a business and you're doing some performance reviews or different things like that. Maybe you have office hours as a teacher and you want to set up appointment slots where students can sign up for appointment slots. Any of those reasons would be a great way to use or utilize appointment slots in Google Calendar. So when we go here, we're going to pick a date, obviously, and we're going to have a time. And when we click on time, it's going to give us some options, right? So let's just do 11 p.m. to, let's do, sorry, 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. And you'll notice once I start clicking on times, we're going to have the time slots here. Now, I can manually change how long I want these slots to be. So let's just say they're 15 minute slots. That's a little narrow from my point of view, but and we're going to click on save. So what this is going to do is it's going to create a calendar, and I'm just going to tell you before we go there, it's going to create a calendar that you can send out to your class, to your faculty, to your department, to whoever is going to be signing up for these slots, and then they can go view all of these slots and sign up for whatever time they want. And then I'll show you what it looks like on the back end so you can manage all of your appointments. So we're gonna do 15 minute slots, right? So we should have 12 of them, 3 hours, 15 times, you know, four, or 15 divided by an hour is four times three is 12. So we're gonna save that. Now when we go here, this is what we're gonna send out. We want to invite those people in our calendar. So this is the calendar's appointment page. And what it's going to do is it's going to take you up to calendar.google.com, but it's a different version. And so you can see here, I have these time slots here in 15 minute increments. So when a person signs up, this is the time slot that they're going to sign up for. So I'm signing up for the 4:15 to 4:30 PM one, right? Now when I go and view and edit in my calendar, you'll see that I have signed up for this time. So let's try with, again, I'm gonna go here and we'll do a different time. And I'm actually, we'll have a different email or just a different header so you can see that it shows different times. I'm gonna click save. Go back and look on view and calendar. So you'll see that both of these events are scheduled here and here, right? Now, if I go back, if I'm another person and I go back and look at the calendar, you'll see that these times are already taken. Like I cannot join and jump into these times, right? I can because I'm in it. If I was a guest, this time would disappear from my calendar. So what does this look like on the back end once you have all of your times filled? Well, if I jump into my regular calendar and I'm gonna do the month view, on June 1st, we have departments checkouts. So We'll go to the day and we'll go to June 1st so you can see each one of our departments is meeting with the principal and the assistant principals. I've put the department head on here, and then the department head went back into the calendar event, invited everybody into that calendar slot. So we're meeting with all of our departments. They're half an hour long. We're going over their schedules for next year, what we expect over the summer, some of the things that we want them to prepare for next year, obviously, depending on how things start the year off. But essentially, this is how you send the calendar invite out in Google Calendar. If this saves you time, energy, and frustration, I would love if you would like, share, and subscribe. If you're here, most likely it's because you're an educator. I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.